Hello everyone. In this session, I'm going to take query of writing lookup transformation. If you want to take training on Informatica, or if you have some query or you need some clarifications on this session, then please don't hesitate to drop me a mail to informatica.training007@gmail.com. So let's begin the query of write in lookup transformation. As I told you or explained to you earlier session, that lookup transformation is used to search a value inside a database table or a flat file at any stage of a mapping. That is the one use of lookup transformation. Another use of lookup transformation is derive a value on the fly. Means at any stage of a mapping, you can use a lookup transformation to derive a value from database table using query overwrite. Let's give you an example of data example. We have employee table, employees src underscore sat table. It has every attribute, as you know. The standard EMP table has the attribute, same attribute we have in the EMP source cell. Now EMP name, ename, job, then manager, salary and department name. Now I want to derive a table which has the same attribute. Along with that, there are two additional attributes: department wise maximum salary or minimum salary. Let's say Blake works in a department 30. So maximum salary and minimum salary will represent the Blake department 30's maximum salary and minimum salary. This table I want to derive. So we have only source table, and I want to derive a target table of these values. Now let's see how we should proceed. So our source table is this table, MP source salary, and target table is this one. So in source table, we have salary attribute. There is no other thing. So in the source table, this is the source table data. If I get department wise maximum salary and minimum salary on the source table, then our work will be done. How we can achieve this? Let's see how to write the query. So select depart number max sal comma min sal from this one MP source and group by department number. If I execute this query on the MP source cell dataset, then I'll get department wise maximum salary and minimum salary. So I have to execute this query. Now how we derive the result set? So we read from source table, and using lookup table, I derive a value, derive max mean salary using lookup transformation. So I read the source table and derive this department number, maximum salary, minimum salary using lookup transformation query overwrite. And this query overwrite, whatever I said, this query will give me something like department number, maximum salary and minimum salary. So 10 department has maximum salary 80,000 and minimum salary is 13,000. So using lookup transformation on the fly, I'll derive this result set, and from the source table I'll derive this result set using lookup transformation, and from the source rows I'll look up this derived result set using department number and get the maximum salary and minimum salary, and we'll populate the target table. This is how we should achieve. Now let's look at the mapping, how we should create the mapping. So close, just I'm closing it. Now I have to EMP source salary. I need to drag and drop. This is the source table. M underscore LKP underscore query overwrite underscore one. I am giving the mapping name like this one. And then I'll drag and drop the target EMP target department salary. So this is my target table. I'll create a expression transformation, may require, may not require. Let's put it here. Department number, I'll just drag and drop. And from the, I just created lookup transformation on the source. Source cell, this is the table. Now, as per the figure, I need department number, max cell and min cell. And department number will come, one department number will come from input. So I have to create a input port. At first I have to create an input port. So let me rename it using in underscore department number, so that we can now in this lookup my department number is lookup port and output port is max cell and min cell. So department number will be in condition. So I'll read the source rows first. We will derive the lookup tab, lookup cache using lookup transformations, which will have three columns: department number, max cell, min cell. And when source row will it comes, then we'll compare the department number of the source row with the cache department number, and we'll get the maximum salary, minimum salary. So these columns are not required. EMP number, ename, in the lookup transformation, these columns are not required. Only salary and department number is required. So I'll discard all irrelevant columns. I need sal, but as per the, as you know, sal is not there, is sal, max sal and min sal. So I just rename it, the sal column, as max underscore sal. Now again I'll just copy and create another port with the same min sal. Main cell. And there is a one, while override the query in lookup transformation, always keep in mind that lookup port, this is our lookup port, lookup port will be at the last, can be at the first or can be at the last. So we'll put, basically we'll follow one practice, that we'll keep the lookup port at the last. Now I have to specify. So first thing, I create the, in the lookup transformation, I create, first I create the lookup transformation on the source, then I create the columns inside the lookup transformation, and then I create a input port, and then after that I just create a condition, department number. Lookup transformation department number should be same as equal to the input department number. Then this is the SQL query override, this property. I just create a standard default SQL query. Let it write and let me arrange the default query which lookup has given me. So my query is arranged. for the clarity, I'll just, this is the max cell, min cell as min cell, and this one. This is the query. Now, before going, just I cancel it. I'll just show the max cell is first port, second port is min cell, and third port is department number. In our query override, default query override generates the query in the same order as the lookup transformation ports arranged. So max salary is first, second is mean salary, and third is department number. So that's why we arrange first the lookup ports in the lookup transformation, and then create the department number. Department number comes as last since we keep it as, and the most thing, important thing is the condition, we keep department number in the lookup condition. Now for clear query, I just remove this. We can keep it, no problem, but I just specifically remove it. We don't require it. If we use it, there is no problem, but I just want to. Now inside this, I just rename this one. I don't touch the as column. As max cell, as min cell, as department, I don't touch. I should write before whatever I want, I should write before this as. As min cell and department number as department number. While writing query override, we should be very cautious that I should not change the as, because lookup transformation only cares about this as. It does not care whatever write inside this. It will execute, but if we miss the as, then there will be a problem. Lookup transformation will not work properly. Now our query is ready. Let me format a little more. This is our query. So I just, in the query override, I just paste it. Okay, apply. Okay, so now just lookup. I just need to rename the lookup max mean cell. This is the name of my lookup transformation. So input row comes department number. It search in the lookup. Lookup internally fires the query in the database and gets the department number, max cell, min cell in the cache file. When I search the department number, it search in the lookup cache file and return max cell and min cell. So our I'm just arranging it. I'll just drag and drop this one. So our mapping is ready. Let me save it. It is saved. Now it is time to create workflow. WF underscore LKP underscore query underscore overwrite underscore one, and I'll just change, since I know my integration service, so I'll change the desired integration service and then created the workflow. The start task has been created, so it is time to create the session. This is my mapping, M lookup query override. I just select. It's being created. Our workflow has been created. Now let's link the task. It is time to create the connection string. Configure the connection string. Source. This is the training source. Source is available in training database. Target is also available in training database. allowing that, I just make it bulk to normal and only insert only, and delete operation I removed and truncate. Before loading it, it will truncate the table. Now I'll just create, configure the lookup database connection string. Everything is done. Okay, apply. Now I'm saving it. It's saved. I'll run it. It's running. One thing I just missed. So it's a group by operation. Group by operation means it's a Oracle group by operation. Group by operation means it's working on a set of group of rows, and group is defined by dependent number. So we have to use group by department number. Now this query becomes complete query. I just run it. I'm just saving it once again. It's saved. Now let me refresh workflow. Workflow is refreshed. Now I'll just save it. Now I'll run it once again. Start workflow from task. Task case has been initiated. It's running. So workflow is complete now. I just read 14 rows and written 14 rows too. So let me verify the result set. So now it is the max cell and min cell is coming for each and every employee. So this is the brief about the lookup query override. Again, just I reiterate the thing. So we read from source table and send the data to the output table, and on the fly inside the mapping using lookup transformations we build a class which has department number, max cell, min cell. This lookup transformation is based on the source table. It will search the source and arrange the data as per department number, max cell, min cell. To derive max cell, min cell, we need to write query override. So we have written a query override this way. So few facts about the query override is, just first define the port order in the lookup. Port order in the lookup. So here it is, we first create a lookup on the source or target, then create or modify the ports, port name, add a new port or rename a existing port. So this is our port order. First is ordering the define. Lookup only ports. This is the only lookup only ports. We don't need a return or something. We just search a value on the department number. So the department number is a lookup only port. So lookup only ports should be at the end or beginning positions of the, in our case it is at the end position. We can keep it in the beginning position also. But better, for the safe practice, always keep the lookup only port at the end of the lookup transformation. Then once again, just we need to get a input lookup input port and then create a lookup condition. Define a lookup condition. We created a lookup condition. Then generate the default query. We have generated the default query by using this one. SQL query override, just open this expression editor and generate SQL. Generate SQL will give you the default query. Modify the default query to meet the requirement. Once default query is generated, then don't change as column, means as and then whatever text is, don't change those one. like as max cell, as min cell, as department number, those should not be changed. Before that, you can write anything, any function, any column, whatever you want to, you can write it. Select column order should be, now we have written the select column, select query, the select query, the max cell comes first, then min cell, then department number. So in the lookup transformation also, those three columns should be arranged in the same way, same order, max cell first, then min cell, and last department number. Then again, so that is the way, once we have written the lookup query override, since it's a group by operation, I have to modify and add the group by operation. Now once query is written, then you have to create a workflow and then configure the lookup connections, source target and lookup connection properties, and then run your workflow. Remember one thing, one more important thing, lookup query override can be done on the lookup on the database table. It cannot be lookup query override. There is no question that we can write a query override for flat file lookup. We only can write query override for database table only. So this is brief about lookup query override. So basically on the first row, when first row arrives into the lookup, lookup fires the query to the database and data, fetch the data and form a lookup cache. So now onwards, lookup finds the, in our case, department number in the lookup cache, and then gets the, derive the maximum or minimum number, minimum salary to the target table. This is how lookup transformation query override works. Now one more condition, I just give it, lookup query dataset, one more thing, same in the same query, what we want to do, this is our input as same. Now instead of department wise max cell min cell, we want to derive overall, on the overall, what is the max cell and min cell of the employee. Means we have 14 employee, earlier we derived department wise max cell and min cell, but overall in 14 employee, what is the maximum salary and what is the minimum salary. So there is no, so in this query, just I'll try to form a query, like our query should look like this one. I don't need it, max cell and min cell, overall max cell and min cell. So we don't need the group by clause. So our query should look like max cell and min cell. Now department wise max cell min cell, we created a department number port, but here since it's overall employee, inside all the employee, who the maximum salary and minimum salary of overall all the employees, so we should not have any lookup port in this query. How to do in this way, how to override query in this case? So for lookup transformation, always we need a lookup port to put in the condition so that we can get the derived record set. So here is the trick, I'll show you the trick. Now we have max cell, min cell, instead of department number, I just put a dummy. Dummy, and here also I put dummy, in dummy, out dummy. Now I just apply OK, and I'll place this I create a dummy port in the expression transformation, and the expression transformation I put a, I just drop it, max cell and min cell. Dummy should be output port, and I make it as a 1. Apply. Okay. Now in dummy, and then I just make it max cell, min cell. Now here I have put a dummy port because we don't have any such lookup port, so we have to create a dummy port in the lookup transformation to get the maximum minimum salary of all the employees. In the condition I'll put the dummy, and then in the lookup transformation I create the generate the default query. So our default query look like this one. Just let me arrange it, replace all. Okay, I'll just copy one more time so that we can get the difference. This is the default query generated by lookup transformation. Now we want to override the query, so same, just I just create the max of the salary as max cell, mean of the salary as min cell, mean of the salary as min cell. Now max cell, min cell, I am not changing here, but before I can change anything. Now emp cell, I just create this one. I am creating a 1, hardcode 1 value, so that my incoming rows can get the, can search the 1 value, 1 as dummy from this one. Now I just overwrite, I just write this query. Okay, apply. Okay, so now it's time to save. I'm saving it. Mapping is saved. Now I'll just refresh the session. Now session is refreshed. I'll just save the session. Session is saved. So I'll run the workflow. Workflow is running. So workflow is complete. 14 rows input, 14 rows output. Then I'll just check the target table. So earlier department wise maximum salary, minimum salary. Now overall max salary is 80,000, overall minimum salary is 9,000. This way we derive. So myth or rule of the story is, when we use maximum minimum over all the record set, then we don't find any lookup ports. At that time we have to create a lookup port, dummy lookup port, which should have hard coded value as 1, 2 or 3, whatever value you choose, a hard coded. In the query override I should put that hard coded value, and from the expression transformation I pass this hard coded value so that it can find, because in this lookup case only single row will be there. In earlier example, department wise lookup transformation has 3 rows, but this maximum and minimum of the department, maximum and minimum of the overall all the salary will have only 1 row in the lookup case. To identify only 1 row, we put a 1 as dummy value so that we can use in a search condition, lookup search condition. That is the way we do it. So this is all about lookup query override. So few facts, just I want to gist it. So lookup is used to search a value. Sometimes lookup is used to derive a value from source, target or any other database table using query override. And query override, in the query override we can do source query, select query clause change, and then where clause change we can change, group by, order by, anything we can change. So how to successfully query override the lookup. So first define the port order in the lookup. In this case you create a new port, you can modify or rename a port, And at the end of the lookup, at the end of the lookup port, keep the lookup, means in the lookup transmission at the end, keep the lookup port. Here the dummy is the lookup port. And then define lookup conditions. Once you define the lookup condition, then only you can generate the default query by using generate SQL. After generating default query, modify the query as per requirement and check select query, select com, this max salary comes first, mean salary comes second, and third is dummy. All things should be arranged as the same as the port order. These three things, if you keep these three things, then you can successfully override the query of lookup transformation. That's all for this query override. Query override is very important and useful, and in the real data warehouse project you can use, or you can see a lot of example of lookup query override, and that's all. So if you have any query or questions, please don't hesitate to shoot me mail to my mail ID is informatica.training007@gmail.com. Thanks for watching this session.